Have you ever wondered how you can jazz up a boring webinar presentation? If you're giving a talk to a group or some kind of training and you want to make it a little bit more interesting, I would suggest checking out the new Zoom feature of using a PowerPoint or a Keynote slide, if you're on Mac, as your virtual background. So the video that you're actually watching right now is of me using this PowerPoint as my video background. And as you can see, I can page through different slides. I can move around my video so that it is not encumbering any of the content. And I wanted to record this so that you could see the features for yourself and also learn how to do it. So if you are in a Zoom meeting, you can open up a Zoom meeting by yourself just to play around with this. It is not under the settings and background feature where all of the other virtual backgrounds are. What you're going to need to do is first share your screen. So you'll see that as the green button in the bottom taskbar. And when the pop-up comes, click on the advanced options. And the very first one should say PowerPoint as a virtual background. So when you do that, you select the PowerPoint file that you want to use as your background. And then what you're presented with is a view that looks just like this. So you can click on your video and move it around. What's really nice is that they have removed all of your actual physical background. So it looks very professional. You can resize it in any way that you wish. And you can also page through the slides just like this. At the very bottom of the screen, there is a little dialogue, very much like how you might browse a PDF, where you can page through or even jump specifically to a slide. So what I'm going to do right now is just stop sharing for a moment. And this time I'm going to select a different PowerPoint because I want to show you some of the limitations of this feature. All right, so here we go. We're back over here and I'm going to just slide this over. Now, as you can see, this is a presentation that I've prepared previously. And unlike a normal slideshow where I have animations, an icon appears, and then when I click, it disappears and a new one takes its place. And that's how this slide is built. As you can see, there is no animation whatsoever. It's just going to show you all of the graphics together. So it's very much similar to if you were to take that PowerPoint and export it or save it as a PDF, everything sort of flattens out, all those layers flatten out, and this is what you see. So you just have to be aware of this when you go to create your presentation, that any elements that build one by one or that layer on top of each other are not going to display the way that you would normally expect in a PowerPoint. So as long as you design for that and plan ahead, you should be fine. So anyways, I hope this was helpful and I really enjoy sharing these tech tips with you. If you like the videos, please comment and like below, subscribe to our channel. And then if you have other questions on technology or cybersecurity or anything else related to how to better run your business using tech, I would encourage you to sign up for our Tech Tips for Business groups in either Facebook or LinkedIn, whichever one that you spend the most time in. And if you ever have any questions and want to have a complimentary one-on-one consultation with me, you can always find me at meetkathy.com. Thanks so much and see you on the next one.